Diego Lowenstein, and I'm the chief executive officer of Lionstone, which is a third generation family business. We have many names. You know, Lionstone is our main holding, but then we have a development entity. We have different type of Lionstone, but we for all the development work and all our property work, it's Lionstone Development. I'm very much, you know, about family. I've been indoctrinated in a family business and heavily relying on family values that have been, you know, passed down from my grandfather, from my father, from my mother, and this is, I think, my premise in life. It's everything is about family. I work one on something that I'm very passionate about, but I work not only with a responsibility to me and my current, let's say, generation, but also with a big sense of responsibility of what comes after. So there's a lot of that in my family. You know, my grandfather escaped the war. He started from nothing, and you know, to have won the fortune to be where we're at today, you know, I don't take it lightly. And I think it's about preservation, about doing, you know, and growing the family business, not only for my benefit, but for the benefit of my children and the rest of my extended family. So that I think is a very, very, you know, strong way I live my life. You know, really thinking about family, the effects of what we do, both in business and outside of business, how it affects, you know, our children and you know what their future will be all about. No? I'm very balanced because I enjoy working. You know, I love what we do. I love the things and the very innovative type of real estate and developments that we're doing, not only here in the U.S. but abroad. But I also have a lot of non-business related things that nurture me, and you know, give me life. And so I think of myself as a very balanced type of person. You know, it's not all work. No, I have you know, strong appetite for other things that you know, fill my life. No, well, Lionstone, we have different silos of business. Okay. This is what we do. We are first and foremost a developer and owner of hotels. Okay. So we like to say we're A to Z. So we basically, from acquiring land to doing the entitlement, to designing, building it, operating, we run the gamut of the, let's say, the whole sector of the hotel.
From the ground floor.
Yeah. So we come up with a vision. We can develop. We've operated hotels, so we have an operating background and an understanding of the hotel industry. We also asset manage, because we have a lot of hotel properties that are not managed by ourselves. Mm. Case in point, the Ritz-Carlton South Beach. So that's managed by Ritz, but we are the owners of that asset. So currently in Miami, we have the Ritz-Carlton South Beach. That's an interesting story, because my grandfather bought that in 1971, that asset. So imagine, it's been in my family for a very, very long time. And
it wasn't a Deco, wasn't it?
It was the DeLido.
It
was built in 1955. So it's one of the bigger properties that were built in this market, along with the Fontainebleau and the Eden Rock in the 50s. And we converted that into the Ritz-Carlton and it opened in 2004. We took a very old building, we gutted it, and then basically then created the Ritz-Carlton there. So we own the Ritz-Carlton Bal Harbour, which is the northernmost, you know, tip of Bal Harbour, which is an amazing asset that we acquired only about a year and a half, 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. And we rebranded into Ritz-Carlton, beautiful product. But my family's had a number of assets that have been with us for decades, and we've traded. Another one that we used to own for a very long time, that my grandfather bought in the early 1970s, is what the addition is. the old Seville Hotel on 29th and Collins.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's the product that you see that is a product of Lionstone, because we entitled that development and then sold that property to Marriott. We used to own this very large office building, which is the corner of Washington and Lincoln Road, which is just two blocks away. It was the largest office building in Miami Beach for the longest time. So that was in my family for over 20 years.
So not just hotels.
Yeah?
Not just hotels.
Not hotels. We've okay. Commercial. We've done shopping center development as an entity. This goes a while back, but we've done shopping center development from here to Palm Beach. We've done single family residential communities. So Lionstone, over its 50 years, has evolved. Today, I would tell you we're much more hotel centric. Today, 90%.
Okay.
Yeah, we're a soup to nuts development firm, so we have all the disciplines.
Mm-hmm.
We don't build. I'm not a contractor. We have no interest in being a contractor. We hire general contractors and subs to do our buildings. We do have architects and engineers, but we also rely a lot on third-party consultants, external architects, external designers. Our people here are more about, you know, controlling the process, coordinating the activities of development. We have in-house counsel, so we can do entitlements. We raise our own construction finance and permanent finance. Depending on the project, some are more complex. You know, we'll put more staff to them. Some are a little bit more simple. We'll rely more on third parties. Real estate is a great business to be in. It's a hard business to be in because one, there's so many variables. And if you look at all the real estate food groups, because you can have industrial warehouses, you can have office, you can have residential, rental, multifamily. Hotels is the most difficult. There's a reason it's the most difficult, because you're not only building a building, it's an operating entity. Every day, you're operating something to make it work. An office building, you build office, you find a tenant, you rent it out for the next 10 years, and you don't worry anymore. Every night, there's an empty room, you never recover that empty room, right? So the complexity of the hotel is, one, it's more difficult to develop because of everything that goes in to a hotel to make it workable. But two, it doesn't end when you finish the product. That's just the beginning.
Yeah.
The success relies on the ability to execute and operate well thereafter.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a complex business. It's very much tied to macroeconomic conditions.
Mm-hmm.
It goes with the economy, so it's a cyclical business. You know, when there's recessions, people don't travel, corporations don't send their people to have meetings. So the industry tends to go by the way of the economy. So one of the big challenges is, if you're heavily concentrated in hotels, is to be able to have good diversity of geography. If you're fully concentrated in one market, you know, could spell trouble if that market get hits.
Yeah.
Case in point, we have Sika in Miami.
Yeah.
You know, it's not a great thing that we're going through, but you know, it's facts of life. Many countries around the world have suffered the same fate, you know, with viruses and it's things that you have to manage. But now, if you're totally concentrated in a market which is resort or Miami, you know, as a company, you're going to have issues. If you're diverse, if you have product in Chicago, you have product in Europe, then you're going to weather the storm in a different way. So we're always looking at the cycle, because the cycle, it can be very kind when it's an amazing, development period. But also when it's a poor cycle, when you go into eras of recession, that's where the best opportunities come. That's when you acquire real estate.
Okay.
That's when you develop. So we're always looking. If we're top of cycle, we're expanding. We're doing capital improvements in the projects to really, outperform everybody, the competitors. When you're in a down cycle, you start looking at opportunities. Where can you buy land? Or you can buy this other building that maybe hasn't performed well and you can turn it around. So we're always looking that. And what happens is, when you have the benefit of working across multiple markets, an up market in one geography might be a low market in the other. So we're always looking at, you know, selectively at different type of opportunities that, and continue to, you know, develop our pipeline.
Okay.